Colin and I are going to visually act out a function that adds two numbers together. The script calls the function with the following line, y equals myAdd parentheses x comma y. The script needs to get these values of x and y and give those to the function myAdd. Notice the script is not handing the variables x and y to myAdd. It just passes the values that were stored in x and y. myAdd now does something with those numbers. The script has no idea what the function is actually doing with the number. When the function is done, it can return values. In this case, the function returns a single number, and the script stores the number that the function returned in the variable y. And now we're done. Now let's go through this again in greater detail. The script is going to hand two values to the function myAdd. Let's peek in on what the function is actually doing. The function is declared with the line function x equals myAdd parentheses x comma z. myAdd is the name of the function. It takes two inputs, which it stores in x and z. myAdd gives one output. The script will take the output and store its value in y. Even though the function has a variable called x, it is not the same x as in the script. We say these two x's have different scopes. The function's x and the script's x can have different values. The script cannot change the value of x in the function. It can only pass a value to the function. And the function will decide what to do with it. myAdd now stores the second value in z. The function takes these two values, adds them together, and stores them back in the variable x. Notice that the variable x inside the function has a different value than the variable x outside the function. This is possible because the two variables are not of the same scope. Now there are no more lines of code in the function. It returns a value, 3 in this case, to the script that called it. The script stores this value in y. In theory, the myAdd function can take any two inputs. In this case, the script is passing the letter q and the number 3. When the function tries to add the values together, it will return a number, but it doesn't necessarily make sense. Because of this, it's a good idea to have your function check to see what the inputs are and make sure that they are what you want. If not, the function should return an error.